Dear students, you know, as mechanical engineers, in due course of time, we all will be using various types of materials. Basically, materials are, as you know, classified into metals and non-metals. And classic examples of non-metals are, for example, wood, glass, ceramics, and so on. And again, in metals, we have ferrous and non-ferrous metals. Now, have you ever imagined why, for example, let's say aluminium is softer than iron, or copper is, let's say, softer than stainless steel, and so on? Now, that is mainly because of the composition of the metal. And we can either have the pure metal, or we can have an alloy of that metal. Now, one of the offshoots or another major branch of mechanical engineering, or you know, it is actually a separate branch of engineering, is metallurgy. Okay, so we in this lab, we have talked about so many properties of materials. You know, we have talked about the tensile strength, compressive strength, bending strength, shear strength, and so on. Now, what is it that gives this kind of a strength to various types of metals? The metals are made up of a lattice. There is a kind of a bonding which is occurring, and we finally decide on the strength, or we decide on the material based on what is known as the microstructure. So we have another important part which is called as microstructure observation. Now, how do we do this microstructure observation? Because if I take any metal which is around us and I try to observe the microstructure, I will not be able to see the microstructure. So in order to observe the microstructure, there is a methodology. There are a few steps that need to be followed. So what generally we do is we take the specimen, and then we have to roll it on sandpaper, taking the grades from rough to very fine. And after we roll it on a sandpaper, we take it to a polishing machine and then we polish it. So the surface becomes extremely shiny, but still we will not be able to observe the microstructure and the grains and the grain boundaries, because there is one more thing that needs to be done, which is called as etching. Okay, so etching is a process where based on the type of material or metal which we want to observe, there are different types of etchants which are available. So we take in the form of a liquid, we take two or three drops of this etchant, and we just smear it on the produced surface, that is that shiny surface. Once we do that, this etchant is going to go and occupy the space along the boundaries, and we can observe it under the metallurgical microscope. Now, again, in material science, you have studied that properties also can be changed by various heat treatment processes. So something which is not very hard can be made hard, at least superficially on the surface, by doing heat treatment. So effectively, what we are trying to do is we are trying to change the microstructure of that particular material. So how do we, for example, whenever I talk about iron, that is ferrous metals, there are various types of irons. We have cast iron, we have gray cast iron, we have spheroidal gray cast iron, we have steel, we have stainless steel, we have high speed steel. So all these materials, how do we differentiate them? One of the ways in which metallurgists differentiate is by observing their microstructure. They can easily identify which material it is. So once the etchant is applied, we use a metallurgical microscope. How is this different from a regular microscope? All of you, or most of you maybe who have studied biology, might have seen a normal microscope. What is the fundamental difference between a normal microscope and a metallurgical microscope? In a normal microscope, it works on the principle of allowing the light to pass through the specimen. Okay, so you when you want to observe the xylem and phloem of plant, you take a very thin slice and keep it on a glass slide and then observe it in a microscope, which has got a certain magnification factor. Now, in this case, obviously, since we want to observe the microstructure of metal, and metal is it does not allow light to pass through it, the concept is slightly different. So what we do here is, in this microscope, we have a light source, and there is a ray of light which goes and falls on the surface which is prepared. So it falls on this surface and gets reflected black. And this reflected light is going to be observed in the eyepiece, and you can observe the microstructure. So the various important things what you need to remember in observation of microstructure is, the first thing is how to prepare the surface for microstructure observation, what is the importance of etchant, and what is the type of microscope which is going to be used. You are not going to use a regular microscope, you will be using a metallurgical microscope which has got a magnification factor of almost about 100x. Okay, so only then you will be able to see the grain boundaries and so on. And as I just mentioned, different metals will have different microstructures. So you know, you can see we have placed a few specimen and the microstructures. These sketches are available in your manual, so you can draw those sketches. But the specimen are also kept here. You can have a look at the specimen and the respective microstructure. So here, you know, you can see this is a spheroidal grey cast iron. That is, in this, the central part, what you are seeing, this is the specimen. So when I observe this under the metallurgical microscope, it will appear something like this. You can see there are blocks or chunks of, you know, carbon which are seen here. This is stainless steel. This is how it looks. And then we have high speed steel that is mainly used for tooling material, you know, the tool which is used in lathe and all, we use HSS. Then we have a grey cast iron where, you know, we have flakes, we have lines like this, you know, these are also called as flakes. And then this is bronze, which is basically an alloy of copper. Okay, so copper and tin, when we mix them together, we get bronze. So, which is mainly, with, you know, this metal is mainly used to make statues or it is used in bushes and so on. So these are the various microstructures, and they are different from each other because you know, the composition itself is different. So this is all, you know, you need to understand about microstructure, and based on the microstructure, the properties of the material are going to change. So all materials do not have the same, you know, microstructure. It will be different from each other, and since it is different, their properties are also different. So, you know, that is all about microstructure and microstructure observation. Thank you.